Would you choose to buy an electric car that could run for more than 1,000 kilometers on a single charge, kept almost all of its battery capacity after 3 years of use, could function normally in a range of temperatures, could be recharged in just 10 minutes, and cost the same as a comparable combustion-powered car? When solid-state battery technology starts to be developed in large quantities in the middle of this decade, consumers will be put in that scenario. By putting several solid-state battery electric car prototypes into operation with the assistance of partner Panasonic, Toyota is attempting to move ahead of the curve. Answer: in today's episode, let's check how Toyota will change the EV race with the introduction of its solid-state batteries. Toyota is investing the majority of its $18.7 billion investment in solid-state technology, which has more than 1,000 patents and is eventually expected to be produced on a massive scale. It's simple to comprehend why. Solid-state batteries have many advantages over existing lithium-ion battery technologies. Solid-state devices work over a larger temperature range, are safer, have a greater energy density, are smaller and lighter, and have a higher energy density. A liquid electrolyte solution is used by lithium-ion batteries, and if it is not handled carefully or suffers damage, it could swell or even ignite. These things do happen, though they are uncommon. After a decade, the storage capacity of some lithium-ion batteries can drop by as much as one-third. The cathode and anode, or more simply, the positively and negatively charged electrodes, respectively, of both battery designs are connected by an electrolyte, which is a chemical combination. Whereas a solid-state battery utilizes a solid electrolyte, the separator in lithium-ion batteries is a liquid solution. Those magnificent and challenging to dose fires are brought on by liquid electrolytes when things go awry. All these problems are solved by solid-state substitutes, which also significantly improve the amount of power that can be stored in a battery. This provides producers with two options: either lower the size of a battery to save weight and space without sacrificing energy, or keep the current dimensions while increasing outputs. It has been known for close to 50 years that a solid lithium metal anode boosts energy density, but we haven't had the technology to actually implement it until recently. This is due to the possibility that mixing lithium metal with a liquid electrolyte could result in stalagmite-like forms that pierce the separator between the anode and cathode and trigger a violent chemical explosion. Today, a number of solid-state electrolytes are offered that function as ceramic separators, have the same conductivity, and lack the risk of blowing up. Samsung's non-automotive solid-state battery prototype has an energy density of 900 watt-hours per liter, compared to the best lithium-ion battery's capacity of only about 700 watt-hours per liter. According to the manufacturer, using this in an electric car would enable the vehicle to drive up to 800 kilometers on a single charge. The battery's lifespan is estimated to be 800,000 kilometers with a life cycle of 1,000 charges. That may be difficult for your uncle's Land Cruiser to match. Taking things a step further, US-based QuantumScape, in which Volkswagen owns 5%, published a study in late 2017 proving the solid-state battery company's cells have an energy density of more than 1,000 watt-hours per liter. Likewise, it was demonstrated that the batteries could charge to 80% of their capacity in 15 minutes and could retain more than 80% of that capacity after 800 recharge cycles. The trick: anode made of pure lithium metal. The battery won't be ready for manufacturing until 2024, at the earliest. The claims made by Toyota are clear. While keeping 90% of its performance after 30 years, it has twice the range of a similar lithium-ion battery. Toyota boasts its solid-state batteries can charge from empty to full in under 10 minutes, making audacious claims once more. Until 2025, according to Toyota, mass production of its solid-state battery is not expected. That's because, although the technology is almost ready for mass adoption, the production capacity isn't there yet. This is true of other players in the solid-state arms race as well. Solid-state batteries, as opposed to conventional batteries, need unique production equipment and procedures. Furthermore, the world has a finite supply of raw lithium, which is just not being produced enough. Toyota also has a fund provided by the government. The Japanese government has built up a war chest of 2 trillion yen, $14.7 billion, which it is using to support industry's attempts to develop innovative decarbonization technologies. The majority of the funds will be used to develop solid-state batteries, namely to buy the necessary lithium. Likewise, infrastructure for the production of solid electrolytes is being built by the Japanese mining and oil corporations Mitsui Kinzoku and Idemitsu Kosa. with the global market for next-generation technology that outperforms existing lithium-ion designs predicted to expand in value from $53.6 million a year to $34.6 billion in 2035, all of this is being done in an effort to gain an advantage over China and South Korea in the battery production arms race. Why is it expanding so quickly? A typical automobile buyer like you, you'll be presented with the same choice in 2035, and major players are laying large sums of money that they already know what you'll choose. Well, although solid-state batteries seem to be the perfect batteries for EVs in the future, there seems to be a major concern that Toyota must address before hitting the production floor. Solid-state batteries in EVs still pose risks. Despite the fact that solid-state batteries have a lot of potential benefits for electric vehicles, there are still some dangers related to the technology. The possibility for a dendrite to form is one of the more dangerous hazards. This happens when tiny fibers develop on the battery electrodes, which increases the chance of a short circuit. Another issue that has been briefly suggested is the battery heating up too much and releasing combustible gases as a result. The possibility of the battery exploding is very real. These dangers have been revealed by reports of occurrences involving battery fires from the Fisker in development. It's vital to remember that this technology is still in development, and that these problems need to be fixed before it can be used commercially. The future of EVs may lie in this promising technology, but it is still in its infancy, and recent attempts to commercialize it have been unsuccessful. This raises questions about how far along it is in development and whether the technology is really scalable for use in electric vehicle manufacturing. Although the technique has produced some encouraging results, it is yet unknown whether these outcomes can be repeated on a wide scale. The driving forces for solid-state batteries for EVs are safety of the technology and performance improvements, and if they can't be sustained on a wide scale, then the movement doesn't seem appropriate to carry out. Additionally, efforts are continuously being made to reduce production costs and increase the energy density of these batteries. These are the factors that keep this technology out for a while. Not just solid-state batteries are being developed to compete in the EV industry. Other rival technologies that will be used in EVs are also in development. Lithium-sulfur batteries are one of the primary rival technologies. These batteries are substantially more affordable to produce while still providing a comparable level of energy density and safety. Lithium-sulfur batteries, but it possesses a substantially shorter lifespan than solid-state batteries, which could be viewed as a major drawback for use in EVs. Another rival is hydrogen fuel cells, which might significantly extend driving distance and charging time. Still, the infrastructure for manufacturing and distributing this technology is insufficient and hazardous. The use of solid-state batteries in electric vehicles may be impacted by these technologies. It is common knowledge that Toyota is also a leader in hydrogen technology, and so whether you want a hydrogen-powered car, an EV car powered by solid-state batteries, you will get it all only in Toyota. Answer: which car are you taking? Let us know in the comment box below. And if you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.